Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yevla. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. From that subject, from the last sum lecture, we are learning the unit number 4, that is the case study on the solar energy application. So student, as we know, the solar energy has the tremendous application in the various fields. But out of that, in the unit number 4, we are particularly going to study the 3 case study where the application of solar energy is done. So, first case study we have seen related to the solar food dryer. Okay. Second case study which we have learned, that is related to the parabolic dish solar cooker. That both case study we have discussed. Now, related to the third case study, that is the photovoltaic system. Solar photovoltaic system, we have discussed some topics and remaining topic we are going to end in the today's lecture. So let's see which topic which we have discussed, that is what is the photovoltaic system that we have seen, how photovoltaic system work, that also we have seen, photovoltaic system and its component also we have seen, then photovoltaic effect we have seen, and lastly we have seen what is the alternate current and what is the direct current. So that point we have discussed up to the last lecture. Now in the today's lecture, the remaining points we are going to discuss, that's are applications of solar photovoltaic system, advantages of solar photovoltaic system, and at the last disadvantages of the solar photovoltaic system also we are going to see in the today's lecture. So let's start one by one. First one, applications of solar photovoltaic system. So where the solar photovoltaic system is applied or used, that we are going to see. So first application, when a number of modules are connected to the grid PV system via an inverter, they transform the DC current generated by the solar PV modules to the AC current. That means what? When number of modules are connected to the power grid, at that time they will generate the DC current, and with the help of inverter we will convert that current into the AC current and we will achieve the AC current. The electricity generated can be used for lighting purpose and powering household appliances. That means what? The electricity in the form of AC current generated by the modules, we will use that for the lighting purpose or household purposes. The excess electricity can be sold to the grid directly. That means excess electricity will be directly sold to the different industries or for power. And second application of the solar PV system is that individual solar PV modules can be used for powering torches, flashlights, wristwatches, etc. and in the remote and rural location also. So the PV system can be also individually used for powering the watch, then flashlight, wristwatch, powering torches also. So that's are some applications where solar PV system is used. So that's are the applications of the solar PV system. Now next point we are going to see, that's are the advantages of the solar PV system. So there are so many application advantages of solar PV system are there, but we will see one by one all the advantages. So first advantage of solar photovoltaic system is that PV panel provides the clean surface. So green energy during the electricity generation with the PV panel, there is no harmful green gas emission. Thus solar PV is a environmental friendly. That's why PV panel provides a clean and green energy. That's are the first advantage. Second advantage is that solar energy is the energy supplied by the nature. That's why thus the free and abundant energy and input energy is a free. That's why it is a less expensive. That is a second advantage. Third advantage is that solar energy can be made available almost anywhere there is a sunlight. That means on the earth most of the percentage you will get the sunlight. That's why sunlight will be easily available. That is the advantage. Fourth advantage is that solar energy is especially appropriate for smart energy network with distributed power generation. That is the DPG, distributed power generation, is indeed the next generation power network structure. That is the advantage. Then fifth advantage is that solar panel cost is currently on a fast reducing track and is expected to continue reducing for the next year. Why that is happened? To reduce the cost of the solar panels and solar product, because in the recent days so many new technologies are developing, and due to that new technologies it is possible to reduce the cost of the solar panels and solar system. So that is the advantage. Next advantage is that photovoltaic panels through photoelectrical phenomenon produce electricity in a direct electricity generation way. That is the advantage of the solar photovoltaic system. And last disadvantage is that operating and maintenance cost of the PV panel are considered to be low. That means operating also and maintaining cost also very low, because all the parts are very long life parts, so almost negligible compared to the cost of other renewable energy system. So that is the advantage, that is maintenance and the operating cost is a lower one for the solar photovoltaic system. So that's some advantages of the solar photovoltaic system, due to which we will prefer to the solar photovoltaic system. Now the last point we are going to discuss, that are disadvantages of the solar photovoltaic system. Though for solar photovoltaic system have the advantages, but along with that there will be the some disadvantages or limitations for the solar photovoltaic system. So let's see which are that disadvantages. As in all renewable energy sources, solar energy have intermittency issue, not shining at night but also during the daytime there may be the cloudy or rainy weather. That means in the cloudy or rainy weather there will be the no sunlights available, so in that day there is no possibilities of working of solar photovoltaic system. That is a disadvantage of the solar photovoltaic system. Consequently, intermittency and the unpredictability of solar energy makes solar energy panels less reliable as a solution, because we cannot predict when there is a sunlight and when there is no sunlight. So that's why it is a less reliable solution. That is the disadvantage. Next disadvantage is that solar energy panels require additional equipments, that's our inverter, to convert the direct electricity to the alternate current in order to be used on the power network. That means that required some extra equipment also. Due to that the initial costing is higher for the PV system. Then next disadvantage is that for a continuous supply of electric power, especially for on-grid connections, photovoltaic panels require not only inverter but also storage batteries, thus increasing the investment cost for the PV panels considerably. Again same points, that means initial or investment cost is higher due to the additional equipment, inverter, batteries. Due to that the initial or investment cost is higher of the PV system. Then in case of the land mounted PV panel installation, they requires relatively large area for the developments. Usually a land space is committed for this purpose for a period of 15 to 20 years or even longer period also. That means large space is required for the setup of the solar photovoltaic system. That is the disadvantage, one of the disadvantage of the solar photovoltaic system. So that's are some disadvantages of the solar photovoltaic system. So that's are the points which we have discussed in the today's lecture related to the solar photovoltaic system. So we have studied application of solar photovoltaic system, advantages of solar photovoltaic system and disadvantages of solar photovoltaic. So like that we have covered the third case study, that is the solar photovoltaic system. So next topic we will continue in the next lecture.